today it's all about having fun as well as challenging you to not focus always on speed but on skill. We want you to get used to breaking. Collect the bottle, make sure you break and then navigate around. Okay?
Boy, oh,
he's
having too much fun. He's having too much fun.
Test your little skills here. I noticed there's a few people that are new today. If you're new, please put your hands up. Fantastic. Where have we got? Four in total. Yeah, would you mind coming over here, please?
Yeah.
Ladies and gents, fantastic. First of all, what's your name and where are you based and how do you care about us?
Jackie, and I heard about you from Instagram, so I've been following you. But we're in the Midlands, so we're just up in London today and tomorrow.
Oh, fantastic. And how long have you been riding for?
Oh, 10 years.
10 years.
I'm doing a big thing in 4 weeks' time. I'm doing the whole Tour de France. A week ahead of professionals.
Hey! So, you're a round of applause for Jackie here.
So, countdown time.
Lord have mercy. We are going to be tracking you and supporting you.
Oh, thank you. Thanks for
making
us feel welcome today.
Well, I'm Andy, I'm Jackie's partner. So we're down in London for a couple of days and we just had the opportunity to come down and ride with you this morning, so we thought we would and hope you enjoy it.
Fantastic. Welcome Andy.
Thank you. I'm Jason from Quicken. And I heard about you guys from my mate, Rob.
Hey, Rob, give a shout out to Rob for that.
Reel him in, Rob.
Welcome. How long have you been riding for?
About 3 years.
3 years, fantastic.
My name's Tino, I'm from Forest Hill, and I've been riding for about two years, on and off, 3 years.
Fantastic. How do you hear about us?
From Jason.
Okay, fantastic. Welcome, Tino. Is it Tino?
Yeah, Tino.
Tino. Welcome, Tino.
Welcome, Tino.
Good morning.
Okay.
Well, today it's all about having fun as well as challenging you to not focus always on speed but on skill. It's zone one over there and this is zone two. Each course is going to sort of challenge you to a different level. Yeah? What we're going to do is we're going to split the groups up like we normally would to a ride captain and then we're going to set you on the course. Okay, any questions at all? Alright, now before we start I need to maybe do a little demonstration for you all, yeah? So, I'm going to get my new bike.
Cue for...
There you go. Check out this bad boy. It's my old new bike, actually, so it needs to be my old bike now, pimped my ride. There you go. So there you go. So ladies and gents, if you don't mind, please clear the circuit for me, and I'll demonstrate what we're going to be doing. Obviously, your ride captains will relay this, and as you do these circuits, we're going to make it a little bit more interesting each time. Depending on what group you're in, we're going to make it a little bit more challenging, okay? Flower
course,
so we're going to expect you to come around, navigate
course.
5 seconds,
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then you come around here, and then you go to a figure eight around this. There you go.
What? Figure break on that?
Okay. And then come through.
That is too
fast. Again.
I'm moving that open.
Do the slalom. Okay. And we're going to be giving you some tips and then come around again.
Well done.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so one of the things Derek just
said to me is that when you're on the inside, sometimes you have to slow a lot more. And that is something to be aware of, is like particularly if we're going around corners or anything like that, it's very good.
that's pro level bottle handover, yeah?
So John, start heading that way.
Ready? 3, 2, 1, go! Remember, you come up at the cone. Oh, very well executed there. Let's go. Bring it on. Who's the next two? If you stand one. No.
Oh,
got it. All right, let's go. You take 2, 1, let's go.
Up.
Nice. Uh-oh, don't touch the cone. Okay, let's go again. Fantastic. Salam. Perfect. And the next time you come through, Ian, you come and pick your bottle up. Okay. The next time. Great. There you go. And what we're trying to do is, we want you to get used to breaking. Collect the bottle, make sure you break, and then navigate around. Okay?
Boys.
Oh, my mercy. He's having too much fun. Nice one. You're either giving me a bottle or you're taking one.
Oy.
Nice one.
Ole.
Nice one. Great ball handover. Yeah, you give me a bottle or you taking one. Thank you. Are you giving me a bottle or are you taking one? Thank you. Great handover. Let's go, Simon. You give me one or you taking one.
Thank you.
Okay. If you're giving me one, let me, you know, start flexing it. There you go, take it. Next one. What are we doing? Great job.
I have to take one.
There you go. Fantastic. Now we're slowing it down. All right, pull it over. Next group on the road is about to go.
It was really good. You did a good job.
Content, so we're going to be putting out some more content. Now, as you all know, after every ride, we do have a tradition of nominating our rider of the day. Right? Now, I was co-ride captain of G2 with Ian. And Hugo. But before we nominate our ride of the day, I just want to touch on a few things, a few lessons that I think we can all learn from my group. So after our ride, we came and we sat down and we had a debrief, right, Jackie, about what we did well, what went wrong. And the aim of all of this is obviously to try and improve and get better each time. And I think sometimes today the theme was impatience. We were a little bit too impatient, too eager to go hard when we needed to just relax. So one example was we had a white van in front of us and we were right on the backside of that van. But you all know, if there's a van in front of you, just sit back because that van might just pull over, it might brake abruptly. So if you're the rider in front, it's your job to make sure you keep a nice, you know, 10 meters away from the van. And then when it clears, you finally have the room to maneuver. Also, after 9 o'clock, we all know that safety-wise, we just have to adapt to our environment because after 9 o'clock, it gets busy. You don't really have a choice how fast you want to go. There's times when you need to neutralize it. For example, when we're going through the danger zone, you know, that's where you definitely need to just relax, navigate through that zone safely, and then have some fun again, and then pick up the pace. So those were the key lessons. And then one other lesson that we picked up was, as we were upping the pace a little bit and it was getting intense, some riders were obviously started to lose contact, right, to the rider in front. In those situations, if you are tiring, it's best you just indicate, let the riders know behind you that you're tiring, indicate, and then speed up a little bit just to pull away, all right? Pull away and let someone else close the gap, yeah? And then sit back. The reason why we work in the park, we do that, is because we're in the park. You can take a lap out. You can do a U-turn, wait for the guys to come back around and jump in again. So don't wait till you're absolutely knackered and then go too late. You're putting other people at risk. Yeah, so if you feel like you're tiring, just let the person know I'm actually gonna pull out and then pull out safely and then let someone else close the gap. You know, do a U-turn and when you see them coming again, your group coming again, latch on, all right? So those were the lessons, but I just thought that today, I want to give a special shout out to Jackie. Jackie was new with us today. And she did a
great job. It used to be lucky dip, but I want to
say. Don't eat it all at once.
We split when we went into the inner circle so that Diana could give a certain set of drills to certain riders, and I was given a different set of skills and drills to the riders that were with me. So we went back into the outer circle. So because of that, please allow us to have two nominations. Okay. So, after you, Diana.
Okay.
Oh, that's outrageous. Yeah. Two nominations.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. It's an ambush.
Okay, well, with the focus on skills today, it was really good timing. So I was in there with Jane and Alice. Alice, as you may know, is doing the Ride 100 next weekend.
Yeah.
Respect.
Stan.
You've got to do it now. And so one of the key things, obviously, to keep hydrated while you're riding and not have to pull over to take a drink. And that was the challenge that Alice was facing. So we spent some time just taking drinks from the bottle and putting it back whilst keeping those legs moving, yeah? And she pulled it off brilliantly, so super proud. And you're all set, girl, so go do it. So she is my rider of the day. Well done.
Save it for next week when you're like 10 miles from the end and like, you just need that.
Okay, I pulled away with two of our newest members, soon to be, Jason and Valentino, and we went back onto the outer circle and practiced our changes. And the rider that really stood out to me, well, both of them were brilliant, but one in particular was really focused and attentive, and the difference between when he started to the end was just amazing. So, rider of the day is Jason. Well done.
So our GT group was just very slick and really kept it well together. A couple of times we needed to think about that juggernaut and can we get past that group if there's road furniture, but we thought about that. It was nice tight pairs. I'll be putting some video up, I hope, which I picked up, which was really good. And then we went to the inner circle and it got very, very, very pacey and very fast, very quickly. And the rider of the day, who was so impressive, and I could see he really gave everything on his 2-inch wheels. Gondo, because I don't know how he did it. He was. You could tell he was really suffering, and I said, keep going, keep going.
And he just stayed and stayed and stayed. Really impressive. So very well done, mate.
I'm not doing that job anytime. Is it?
Jules, Anton and I, we had G3. Again, it was a really good session. I think we took a lot of the skills that we got from the kind of first part of the day onto the road. And what was really nice is to see everybody, every time we pulled off from the traffic lights or went around the corner, there was a real kind of conscious effort to wait for that all on before we started going. So that was nice because it kept us all together as a group. And then also there were some good decisions where we had somebody who, I don't know why, every time we slowed for a light or something, he overtook us and then just sat in front of us.
And he went right in front of us.
And then we overtook him again and then the light changed and then he came and sat back in front of us again and slowed down. So we made, there were some very good decisions made to not crowd him off the road, to just let him do his thing, whatever that was. Yeah. And so I thought that was very impressive. There was a little bit in the middle where the communication went a little bit and we were kind of a little bit all over the road, but there was a quick reminder from Anton and Jules and everybody kind of straight back into line. So it was an overall really good session. And because we like to be outrageous as well, I don't want to get told off now. We're going to have two nominees as well.
Yeah.
So I'm going to give Anton first for his nominee and then Jules has got one as well. So Anton.
Thank you. Today, first of all, I thought, guys, we did do really well. Everyone worked well as a team. And yeah, there was one sort of minor incident where the communication got a little bit wayward. But overall, I think everyone really focused on making sure the calls go from the back to the front and the back and vice versa. And that really helped us to ride safely. My ride of the day today was safe, was consistent, and was also very strong. And so that goes to Ron.
Hey.
Right, okay. Well done, my friend.
Yeah, I just want to say, so this young man, he's not a stranger to BCN. I really liked how, I mean, it's all good and well us ride captains, we're sort of, you know, we're basically just trying to pull everyone in line and trying to encourage and everything. Well, he was doing that himself, mm-hmm. which was kind of showed that he's getting involved and he kind of sees the importance of safety and formation and everything. So pretty impressed with that. You know, his fitness, you know, just doing everything right, basically. So I'm going to give it to Colin.
Yay! Well done, Colin.
Thanks.
That was really emotional. That moved me.
I'm not a man that I don't talk a lot.
Let the legs do the talking.
I can't talk, man. I'm too emotional.